Well, there is another debate tonight, and it will be hosted by CNN and the Des Moines Register at Drake University, and it will feature six candidates: Bernie Sanders, Joe Biden, Elizabeth Warren, Pete Buttigieg, Amy Klobuchar, and Tom Steyer. Now, essentially, I have four people up on the screen behind me because those are the only individuals who actually have a chance, and who this debate is actually either going to help or hurt the most. They have the most on the line. So what I want to do is talk through what I think we can expect. By the time you all are seeing this, most of you are seeing this, we'll just have had the entire drama between Elizabeth Warren and Bernie Sanders, in large part because Elizabeth Warren most likely planted that story. So will we see that at tonight's debate? I think a question on this will certainly come up since CNN was originally the source that broke that story. They're going to be hosting this debate, so you can expect a portion of time to be dedicated to that, and expect to be incredibly disappointed because I don't believe that they will give Bernie Sanders a chance to explain himself and defend himself properly, although if they do, I will stand corrected and be very happy to be wrong about that. Now, basically, Bernie Sanders is walking into a lion's den tonight. He's always a target for attacks, not just from the other candidates, but from moderators as well, usually, and now he is surging in the polls. So understand that this will probably be the most harsh debate for Bernie Sanders. He will have to defend himself. And if I were Bernie Sanders, the way that I think I would proceed is I wouldn't go on the offensive as much. I would simply make my case. But whenever I am attacked, and he will be attacked, you know, it's inevitable at this point, rebut with a counterattack. So if Elizabeth Warren attacks you, attack her back and say, well, she doesn't go far enough. She doesn't want to cancel medical debt. If Joe Biden attacks you for saying that Medicare for All is too expensive, then you attack him for saying that he didn't find a way to pay for the Iraq war that he voted for. So Bernie Sanders, what he should be able to demonstrate is that he cannot just withstand the attacks, but he can counterattack, and he needs to prove to voters that he will be strong against Donald Trump. And that means also calling out the media's most likely biased questions that they will pose to him specifically, right? He needs to basically make this a masterclass in debating Donald Trump and prove that he's strong against the other candidates and therefore will be strong against Donald Trump in a general who is already attacking Bernie Sanders. And he's demonstrating a lot of strength amid these attacks from Donald Trump. There's an article from BuzzFeed News that states Trump is kind of fixating on Bernie Sanders. So Bernie has handled those all great. He needs to do that here. Take the gloves off, be absolutely brutal with the counterattacks, but don't go out of your way to attack another candidate on stage, because when you're starting to get into the lead, you really just have to maintain, right? But he's going to be attacked, but he's got to hit back really hard, really fast, and be able to concisely rebuke, you know, these attacks that are lobbed at him inevitably. So if I am Joe Biden, he's got to have a phenomenal showing. He really is at an iffy standing. He has kind of pulled ahead in early primary states. Him and Bernie Sanders are basically statistically tied in Iowa and New Hampshire. So Joe Biden has got to prove that he is the front runner. He can't have too many brain farts. He can't be weak. He can't be the subject of everyone else's attacks. He has got to come out on top of this debate if he really wants a shot, because this is the last debate before Iowa. So he's got to make a strong case for himself. Will that happen? I don't know. Most of his debate performances have been incredibly poor. That last debate, I think he actually did a good job, namely because he didn't really talk that much, right? But if he is talking a lot more, I think that that is time for him to demonstrate why he's not really suited for this. So all I know is it's do or die right now. Joe Biden, he can't just, you know, fade into the background. He's got to have a strong showing. If I'm Elizabeth Warren, my task exclusively, basically my only task, is to win back progressives. She has pissed off all of Bernie Sanders supporters by going negative against Bernie Sanders while trying to disingenuously frame herself as the victim of Bernie's attacks. No, we see right through you, Elizabeth Warren. You need to win back Bernie Sanders supporters. So give us context, clarify the situation, defend Bernie Sanders. If you truly believe that what Bernie Sanders said to you in that closed door meeting was meant to be sexist, then also call out Joe Biden for the same thing. He said the same thing. He recently said that he wouldn't be subject to the sexist attacks as women. So he's basically boasting about how I'm a man and I'm stronger against Trump. Call him out. Be consistent. Don't just make it seem like you're trying to siphon away progressive voters from Bernie Sanders for, you know, your benefit, right? Now, not only does Elizabeth Warren need to win back progressives, but she has got to be incredibly aggressive. She's got to hit Biden and she's got to hit him hard. Because what she did, this attack on Bernie Sanders, I don't think it is going to help her, but I do think it's going to help Biden. You know, when both Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren go at it, Biden will benefit from that, right? So she's got to make up for what she did now and attack Biden, attack Buttigieg, but not attack Bernie Sanders. She needs to avoid that because, as she learned, when you attack someone who's a progressive, we don't take you seriously. We don't view you as part of our movement. And she's claimed that she's progressive. Now she's been inching closer and closer, you know, towards the center throughout the course of this primary. Nonetheless, if you truly are serious about uniting both wings of the party, you need to make it up to us at this debate. You need to attack Biden and Buttigieg. Be the attack dog for Bernie Sanders after what you did. Now, Pete Buttigieg, if I were him, I'm pulling out all the stops because he needs to have a damn good night. He is no longer surging. He's no longer viewed universally as the front runner according to mainstream media. His poll numbers are sinking. He needs to have a good night. This is basically his last chance to make an impression on voters before Iowa. If he doesn't perform well in Iowa, odds are he's not going to have the momentum needed to carry him throughout the rest of the primary, and it may be donezo for him. So he needs to make sure he brings out all the big guns. He needs to understand that he is competing for that centrist space with Joe Biden, and Joe Biden is overall the front runner, more so than Bernie currently. So if I am Pete Buttigieg, I'm going to pull an Elizabeth Warren, and I'm going to attack the person ideologically who's closest to me in hopes of siphoning off his voters. So Pete Buttigieg needs to make an aggressive case against Joe Biden that he is the one who centrists should unite behind if they truly want to beat Donald Trump and they think that a centrist can beat Trump. Now, I don't think that a centrist will win against Trump, but if I'm Pete Buttigieg, a self-interested opportunist, that's the case that I'm going to make. Now, when it comes to Amy Klobuchar and Tom Steyer, they're hanging on for dear life at this point. Each of these debates, Amy Klobuchar in particular, has gotten a lot of talk time, a disproportionate amount of talk time relative to where she stands in the polls, right? So I don't even know what she can possibly accomplish. After that last debate, there are a lot of pundits like Chris Saliza that said she won big, zero effect in the polls. You see her ticking up in early primary states, but by and large, she's not doing well in spite of the fact that the media is desperately trying to push her into that frontrunner status as Pete Buttigieg slips. So she has to do something different this time. She can't keep up with the same strategy, right? She's got to actually come to the table with policy solutions and not just shit on progressive policy solutions. Because every time she shows up to these debates, she basically just says what we can't do. So now it's time for her to put up or shut up. Tell us what we can do, what she is offering, what is her vision. Because we know what isn't her vision. She doesn't believe in progressivism. She doesn't want Medicare for all. Okay, great. So tell us what you support now. Make your case. When it comes to Tom Steyer, I don't really believe that there's anything he can do. He barely qualified for this debate. He's hanging on for dear life. So best case scenario for him, he talks enough to where that increases his name recognition and he qualifies for the February debate. But at that point, will it really matter? I don't think there's really anything he can do. He's just lucky he made it on to that debate stage. But it's time for him to seriously think about wrapping this up because he has spent millions upon millions upon millions of dollars and it's not helping him at all. In fact, Mike Bloomberg jumped in and is admittedly outraising him but already outpolling him as well. So Tom Steyer, I mean, I don't know really why he's here. He shouldn't be included in this debate, one, because he's a billionaire, and two, because he has no shot at the nomination. There was one poll that seemed like an outlier where he came up at 15% in South Carolina. Well, unless there's other polls that also show those same results, I have to assume that poll is an outlier because of how bad he's doing nationally. He's not really catching on. Nobody's talking about him. Even the mainstream media has largely ignored him in favor of the other billionaire, Mike Bloomberg. So this is basically about him qualifying for the next debate, even though that won't help him as well. So that's it. I'm not sure how long this debate will be. I'm assuming 2 to 3 hours long. I hope that we get a debate like the last debate where Bernie Sanders takes the gloves off and is more aggressive. I'm assuming he will be aggressive in the event he is attacked. I don't expect him to go on the offensive, but I do want him and hope that he defends himself, right? Because you can't just allow all of these candidates to attack you from different angles. You're going to possibly have Elizabeth Warren attacking him from what she hopes is the left. You're going to have people attacking him from the right. So he has really got to make the case for himself. And for Bernie Sanders, this is about proving that he just took on, you know, all these five candidates and he handled them with ease. Watch what he's going to do to Donald Trump. If he can take on all five people at once, then he can definitely take on Donald Trump. That's basically what Bernie Sanders needs to communicate. But we will wait and see, and you can look forward to my full debate analysis after the debate. I will post it the morning after, so definitely look forward to that, as well as some clips, you know, where I talk about the highlights. So we'll wait and see, but hopefully this debate will be good for Bernie Sanders, because now it is make or break.